Oh, Mr. Holmes, do forgive me.
You are?
Nanny Baskerville, my brother Sir Henry Baskerville. Recently, my brother received a letter warning that he would die at the fangs of a gigantic ghost town.
What more letters?
Miss Baskerville, downstairs at once. We've got a moment to lose.
Thank you.
Watson! Come along, Watson, the game's afoot.
I shall never forget you, Sherlock Holmes.
I remember praying one night. I was like, Lord, I really don't know what show we need to do. And then after I finished praying, I remember this. I got a thought in my head, the Hound of the Baskervilles. And I was like, well, I wonder if there's a Hound of Baskervilles show for girls or something like that, or something Sherlock related. And it took me one Google search, and the top hit was The Hound of the Baskervilles, a comic thriller starring Shirley Holmes and Jenny Watson. What people might not realize is actually how much work goes into a show before you even begin the audition process. I got the scripts, I went through them, made some minor tweaks, made sure everything was good legally, and started developing the set design. And I worked with Ben Biddle, Liz Biddle, and we came up with something really, really cool. We started to make 3D layouts and everything. Me and Ruth started going over the show, like what is needed, who do we need, how can we cast this, and then we began auditions. It was important for me moving forward that I got myself a good grasp on who Shirley and Jenny needed to be as a group and as individuals. And to do that, I decided to put Liz and Hannah through an acting boot camp.
Boot camp. Well, so it's a very interesting experience. I haven't really done anything like that before. But it was nice to just kind of dig down, find the root of the character without doing anything with the script and just having fun with it.
I was really worried at first, not gonna lie. I was like, oh dear, what is he gonna make us do?
Let's improv as your character. Like, be Shirley Holmes, be Jenny Watson, but we're just gonna improv stuff. We did deductions. I played a client, they interviewed me. We did just the two of them in the flat, having an argument, talking about love.
Liz, you don't forget love. Try to explain love.
Be able to develop our characters and just do weird things in terms of acting that we'd never done before was really stretching and a lot of fun.
But boot camp was pretty fun.
We are in the gym for our first set day today. Going to tear down the set of Oz and start building Baskerville.
Oh no,
the house. Let's go, people. No time for eating. More working. How's it going over here, ladies?
Good. My arms are tired.
It's got a really pretty picture.
Yep, and we're gonna paint over it. This might be the first production in a long time where we get the set done in a reasonable amount of time. And it's raining. Lots of rain. It's raining all day. Cold. And wet and muddy and dirty. Need a shower.
Three guys.
Blinded you.
Like that. Like this hardest. Right. No. Wait, no. This has no fur. No.
Alright.
Look at the shoes.
It all on.
Get the shoes.
I know. I've seen the shoes.
I love
the
shoes. I love the pants.
And of course, this is the studio. This is my favorite place in the world.
Just kidding, that's not our theme. What's our theme, Drew?
Shirley, Jenny, tell us what we're doing right now.
Advertising, obviously.
Mm-hmm. For your latest adventure.
Done all on our own, too. They helped our uncle Sherlock. Oh, Uncle John.
Mm-hmm. You don't need their help.
No.
So I have just finished the Hound of the Baskervilles poster. We started with an original image. Originally it had a lot more blood on it. I had to take that out. I had to make the silhouette of the hound illuminate more and give it the bloodshot eye, have it illuminate green. And then in terms of the characters, you know, we after a poster shoot, you have to pick the best ones and then do some editing. And there's some filters I put on it that are ever so slightly make it look like it's actually one with the parchment. It's really subtle, but it kind of helps those images look like they belong together. And after that, it was just kind of a lot of finishing touches and making it blend nicely. No, this has been such a fun project to do. And if that reflects, you know, the amount of fun that I have with these kids actually making the show, then people are going to be in for a nice product.
Behind the scenes of train bouncing. Let's see it, folks. Yeah, so let me see the napping while you're bouncing. Choo choo!
You went wrong.
Yes, in the beginning it was very, very chaotic. Once the guys got more comfortable with their lines and their blocking and how the scenes were supposed to flow, we started to see enormous progress.
As you value your life or your reason, keep away from the moor.
Hello, Chance.
Mm-hmm.
Hi, Jannik.
Mm-hmm.
Just some.
Oh, nice meeting you.
Get your feet out. Oh, no, you're not!
We came to fall break and all the kids were gone. We had 1 week off, but I did not. And I took that time to work on a lot of stuff for the show. We met for a set day.
Lunch break. On a work day, video blog here.
Not too many of us came today.
Yeah. just
the faithful ones. And then we've got someone with a bum leg here.
That is awesome.
I'll hang on to these for you. Wall is done drying.
No, not
the
door.
No.
Failing.
Let's go.
Trying not to get paint on themselves. Struggle's real.
The week off also proved to be a really great time for me to work on the soundtrack, which is a huge element of the show.
Hey there. So it is past 2 in the morning. I have been working very, very hard on the Hound of the Baskervilles soundtrack.
But the main focus of that week off was for us to create the hound. Now when you look at illustrations and literature of Sir Arthur Conan Doyle's story, you see this great big beast that's luminous and has red eyes, it's dark and black, and it's just terrifying.
Look at that.
It even has
a retina and everything.
Really, the main inspiration was my dog, Link. You know, I have a husky, and we had one point thought about a real dog, but my dog was never going to make the cut because he's just too crazy.
It's so cool.
Thing off the bottom of the. Okay.
And there's our hound. How do you feel about it?
Oh, hot.
Hot.
Yeah. And she's shedding.
Yeah, she was definitely cold.
I finally finished all of my set layouts for the entire show of Hound of the Baskervilles.
Tonight is going to be exciting. We're going to rehearse with just Liz, Hannah, Caleb, and Wes, and get our two Holmes and our two Watsons together. And, I think people will be blown away.
Heading in now. I'm the first to arrive, of course. Bum.
We're here.
He's back.
Miss me?
Ooh.
Watson, come back.
What? Turn it around, dude.
Turn this around.
This is behind the scenes.
Of our surprise extra scene.
It's a surprise, be quiet.
And how's,
no yet.
And how's it going so far?
Fantastically.
It couldn't honestly be better.
Shut up,
we've done all our lines memorized.
They have all their lines memorized.
Oh. What I'm learning is that this is a show that does not mess around. We are still crafting these scenes and crafting these characters, so it's not like we have that down and we just need repetition. Like, we're still crafting the show.
So I'm gonna actually have them start doing those lines, and we'll just have you bring in the walls, okay? In the bed.
But we just need to move these three walls in the bed, and that's it. So let's figure out who's doing what. Communicate. Know your job. What was that, 30 seconds?
We were all on stage. Because it was literally everyone. You were like, everybody, shut up!
From time to time, I lose my cool, but that's not what the cameras get to see. Because we're going to show that we just had a great time.
It's magical.
Literally a sophomore.
I was like, you don't get to yell at everybody. Yeah. I get to yell at everybody. Oh.
Well, hey, you're going through this. You're doing this.
You, that's true.
I'm for you. This is for you.
Okay.
To look back
how
on.
How much time do you have? Come on, let's go. I need to share my grievances.
It's production week. That's right. It's here already. I feel like we should have more time, but alas, there's no more time.
Just catch you, hear me?
Yeah, I'll catch
you. This is how I help, by not helping.
That's true.
I just video it.
So it's 11 o'clock now.
It's only
how long do you guys think we'll be here?
So the only thing I don't really have is this.
I just plugged stuff in. Or they don't find the thing, so.
That's one of our lighting technicians, folks.
Yep.
Where is it going?
You don't need to be trained. You just have to plug stuff in.
That's all it takes.
Okay. Finally. Going home. It is 11:53. Nope. 12:53. Gosh. Gabe, gotta go home.
Let's get something back to basketball hall. Everybody grab something.
Because when I first picked up a script and I started to read through it, I kept going, man, when are Sherlock and Watson going to show up in this thing? Starting tomorrow, Kayla and Wes will be here and they will be in the show.
Yeah. Cool.
Hey man.
I like your flower.
It's gross. I found it. In a closet, so.
Future Drew will probably put a picture up.
I'm trying to get the individual hairs.
Uh-huh. They're back! Woo!
Big reunion.
Yay! Hi, Mrs.
strip. I'm trying to hold my suit up with my elbow, which is why I'm walking.
I gotta be careful, otherwise the video blog will become about this. How do you feel like the show went last night?
Coconut oil, and then I use like the essential oil, coconut oil, and then I use like my moisturizer, and I just like kept moisturizing.
Fantastic! We freaking killed it.
That was worth the wait. There she is.
Woo-hoo!
Hello.
Match day. Big day. Saturday show.
Woo! Oh, you're being filmed, Carol.
She's a mad woman.
Always, gas house Gertie.
Gas house Gertie for life.
Anna! 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 Anna!
Anna!
She's
right here.
There you go.
Well done.
Wait! Anna, that was the wrong mic.
So much more to come.
You found your purse, did you say?
I did, yes. I give my body and soul to the powers of evil to recapture my minions!
Gigantic hound, Miss Holmes. I know what I saw. Watch your back. Hurry now, you'll be late. And Jenny Watson, hi. Very pleased to meet you.
My wife, Elizabeth. Mm-hmm.
Yes, I did. I heard it.
True. Most likely Sir Henry.
That's all you're
thinking. The sound of fear.
Write me a letter, girlfriend. I can't wait.
The time has come for women to take their rightful place in the scheme of things.
Waving that silly looking butterfly like a madman.
You've been a great help with this goofy love stuff, Miss Watson.
Why, thank you.
You're like the little sister I never had. So then, he's the escaped convict.
Please, as you're a gentleman, burn this letter and be at the gate by 10 o'clock.
When it was all said and done, I looked up at that stage with so much pride because these kids had given me the greatest gift. The gift to just sit there, not worry, and just enjoy the show like a regular audience member. And that's what happened. These guys did it and they pulled it off. I remember there's a moment after the show I looked up on stage and I saw both generations of Holmes and Watson getting a picture and 221B, and I just broke down and cried because this represented two generations and 2 years of hard work of creating two great shows, and I just thought, we did that. We did that together. I'll never forget it. And I'll never forget working with this amazing group of kids. Actors. Because that's what they are. They're serious actors. And I'm so blessed to be their director.